Toastmaster Arnav.
September 11th, 2001, 8:46 a.m. American Airlines Flight 11, with 92 aboard, traveling at a speed of 470 miles an hour, strikes the North Tower of the World Trade Center. With one tower in flames, the tragedy is only beginning. It's 9:03, United Airlines Flight 175, with 65 aboard, traveling at a speed of 590 miles an hour, smashes into the South Tower of the World Trade Center. The South Tower lasts only for a few minutes before it succumbs at 9:59. Dust clouds spread around, victims stagger away, and then all you see are people jumping off the towers. People crying and running. All you hear are screams and sirens, and all you feel is panic and suffering. And at 8:38, the North Tower spears straight down. Chaos in New York City. Power is down, phone lines are jammed, hundreds of firefighters are trapped in the towers, hundreds more race to the scene. Falling debris from the North and South towers ignite fire in the neighboring buildings. World Trade 4, 5, and 6 are ablaze. World Trade 7 burns unchecked for 7 hours. And at 5:20, collapses. A state of horror, and perhaps the longest and most tragic day in New York history. Greetings, Toastmasters. We all face tough times, don't we? Some break you, some make you. When I look back, I feel I was privileged to have everything sorted. Family, friends, health, until the end of last year, when everything, literally everything, started to slip away. All of a sudden, my mother was diagnosed with high blood pressure and it didn't seem to get under control. For months, endless circles of hospitals from one to the other, different medications, different treatments, nothing seemed to work. There were ruckus in the house all the time, and yet again, with one time in flames, the tragedy was only beginning. Soon, my younger brother, under the colossal wrath of the JMANC, fell into depression, severe depression. He couldn't eat. Whatever he had, he puked out. He stopped talking to everyone. His health kept on deteriorating and deteriorating every single day, and he became so terrified that he couldn't sit alone in a room. His voice kept on lowering and lowering on every subsequent call. There was so much going on, so much to manage, and endless emotional baggage. So much going on and so little I could do, I just felt I cannot push through. Consequently, I became restless. I became impulsive. I started to distance myself from people. This club, which I loved so much, started to feel like a burden. My friends started to scare me, and the friends whom I told I would take a bullet for you, would have never known that I would pull the trigger. I lost friends. I lost that bond with my family. I lost my happiness. I lost sanity somewhere. I lost myself. There was so much going on, I became numb. People ask me, Arnav, what's going on? Do you wish to share? Do you want to vent something out? And I just had one answer. I don't know. Arnav, why have you stopped talking? Have you forgotten me? Do you even care? Arnav, are you okay? Is everything alright? I don't know! I just don't know. I used to cry the whole night thinking about who to love and who to care. Bottled up with so many things, didn't know with whom to share. All I wished was that if just everything would get back to normal. Back to the way it was before. But you know what, ladies and gentlemen? On September 11th, when those attacks happened, there were people who had their offices in the World Trade Center at that time, but they're still there. You know why? There was a woman whose alarm clock didn't ring, and that's why she was late. There was a man who missed his bus. There was a man who threw food on himself and needed time to change. There was a man whose car didn't start. Do you see something in common? Everyone would have been cursing their lives at that moment for getting it. Who knew it would have purpose? Ladies and gentlemen, everything has a purpose. Now, I have friends who cry when I have to leave, and there are still friends whom I cry for because their broken hearts I couldn't be. I finally have a brother who is happy because he got into a better college than me, and proud parents to save their children where they ought to be. So, is everything normal? Back to the way it was before? Definitely. Something's are. So did it all have a purpose? The same answer. I don't know. But ladies and gentlemen, one thing that I do know is that it will. And that if all of you are going through something, if you're struggling and if things aren't normal, there's one thing that you need to do. Just keep pushing through. Because everything has a purpose.